Hello and welcome to part 8 of the third of the 3 weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. At this point of the course on Jet, you should be well aware of the fact that Jet focuses on reusing existing technologies rather than reinventing the wheel. That approach is true for the tasks outside of the creating and the development of Jet applications too. For example, while you might have used tools like Ant and Maven if you're familiar with Java development, for building your applications in the JavaScript ecosystem, Grunt is a widely used alternative, represented by this scary guy that is Grunt's official logo. For most things you're likely to be doing, you won't need to know anything about Grunt at all. Once you have the Oracle Jet command line interface installed, which you did right at the start of the course, you should be able to use the commands that we'll be looking at in this part. We recommend that you go to gruntjs.com and that you explore that site thoroughly, since under the hood, you'll be making use of Grunt heavily throughout the work you'll be doing with the Oracle Jet command line interface in the context of its build commands. The Grunt site provides a lot of information and tutorials, as well as a well-established community. But again, you shouldn't need to know too much about Grunt in detail when working with Jet applications, though it's always good to know where to go when you want to do something special. Invoke OJet build, and you'll notice that by default, a web folder will be created containing your artifacts. As you've learned throughout this course, do not write your code in that web folder. Instead, write your code in the source folder, because the web folder will be overwritten whenever you do a new OJet build. The web folder is called web because web is the default platform for Jet applications. After all, by default, Jet applications are web applications that are used in the browser, on the desktop, on tablets, and on mobile devices. A related topic is that of theming. The Jet Developer Guide has a whole chapter dedicated to this topic. Themes consist of CSS style sheets, icons, and other artifacts that change the appearance of your Jet applications. At build time, you can switch between different themes that you have defined for your Jet applications. The add theme argument is used as part of the Jet command, and then a theme folder is created, which can be included in your build when you run OJet build. In conclusion, Grunt, the very widely used JavaScript task runner, is used under the hood by the Oracle Jet command line interface. It is a standard part of Oracle Jet applications. You use it for bundling your artifacts, as you've seen in this part of the course, and you can run it from the command line. Your homework for this part is to explore the related section in the Oracle Jet Developer Guide and find the references to Grunt in particular, where they relate to building your application. Explore the various build options in the Oracle Jet Developer Guide and use them in the applications that you have been creating throughout this course. Finally, as always, many thanks for participating in the course on Jet, and see you in the next part.